Hi guys, today let's understand the question and answers of the lesson Appa. Shabdarth, word meanings. Dakhila means admission. Tajurba, anubhav means experience. Duble, kamzor means weak. Yakin, vishwas means trust. Andaz, dhang means style. आत्मविश्वास अपने पर भरोसा हैविंग सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस शर्मिंदगी एम्बैरेसमेंट इट मीन्स इन हिंदी शर्मिंदा होना टू बिकम एम्बैरेस्ड कामयाबी तरक्की मीन्स सक्सेस प्रशंसा तारीफ प्रेज समवन खामोशी चुप्पी मीन्स साइलेंस बेहतरीन बहुत बढ़िया मीन्स वेरी नाइस खान सामा रसोईया मीन्स कुक और शेफ शबाना आजमी के दिमाग में क्या न समाता था वॉट वॉज शबाना आजमीज माइंड नॉट एबल टू एक्सेप्ट क्या न समाता था मीन्स वॉट वॉज इट नॉट एबल टू एक्सेप्ट शबाना आजमी के पिता दूसरों के पिता जैसे नहीं थे Children here, there should be a full stop. यह बात उनके दिमाग में नहीं समाती थी Shabana Azmi's father was not like other fathers. This is what her mind could never accept. शर्मिंदगी किस बात की थी वह गौरव में कैसे बदल गई What was the point of embarrassment and how did it turn into a matter of pride? Here, sharmindagi means embarrassment, gaurav means proud, badal gayi means turned. Shabana ke pita angrezi nahi jante the. Shabana's father did not know English. Is baat ki sharmindagi thi and she was embarrassed about that. Unke pita ka naam akhbar mein chapa. Tab se ve apne pita ke liye gaurav anubhav karne lagi. Her father's name got published in the newspaper. From then onwards, she started feeling proud of her father. Akbar means newspaper, Chapa means it got published. Gaurav means proud, pride. Anubhav karne lagi means started feeling. Khane ke baare mein Abba ke kya vichar the? What was her father's thoughts or Abba's thoughts about food? Vichar means thoughts. खाने के बारे में उनका विचार था कि उत्तर प्रदेश का खाना सबसे अच्छा होता है. About food, he believed that the food of Uttar Pradesh is the best. Now, किसने किससे कहा? Who said what to whom? पिछले दिनों टाइफाइड होने की वजह से अब्बा अचानक इतने दुबले हो गए हैं कि पहचाने नहीं जाते फॉर सम टाइम इन द प्रीवियस डेज बिकॉज ऑफ टाइफॉइड फादर हैज बिकम सो वीक दैट वी आर नॉट एबल टू रिकग्नाइज हिम पिछले दिनों मीन्स इन द पास्ट फ्यू डेज अचानक मीन्स सडनली दुबला मीन्स वीक शबाना आजमी ने वाइस प्रिंसिपल से कहा मैंने तुम्हारे अब्बा का नाम अखबार में पढ़ा है आई हैव रेड योर फादर्स नेम इन द न्यूज़पेपर। शबाना की सहेली ने शबाना से कहा सहेली मीन्स फ्रेंड सो शबाना'स फ्रेंड टोल्ड हर कल रात एक मुशायरे में मैंने तुम्हारे अब्बा को देखा यस्टरडे नाइट इन अ कंसर्ट I saw your father. Mushaira means concert where all the poets they come and recite their poems. वह उन अब्बा से बिल्कुल अलग रहे थे जो parents day पर school आते हैं. He was looking totally different from the parent who or from the father who would come to school on parents day. Who said this to whom? Vice principal ने शबाना से कहा. सेकेंड पैराग्राफ मुझे याद है महाराष्ट्र स्टेट प्रतियोगिता के लिए वे एक ड्रामा पगली की तैयारी कर रही थी I remember. She was preparing for a drama for the Maharashtra state competition, and she had the role of a mentally unstable person. Pratyogita means competition. Pagli means mentally unstable, someone who is not mentally stable. उन दिनों वे अपने रोल में इतनी खोई रहती थी कि आपसी बातचीत भी पगली के अंदाज में करने लगती थी. Those days, Hamad, she was so much absorbed in her role as a pugli that even while talking to each other, sometimes she would talk in the style of a pugli. Andaz means style. कभी धोबी से हिसाब लेते हुए, कभी रसोई में खाना पकाते हुए. At times, she would act like a pugli while she was, settling accounts with the laundry person. And at times, in the kitchen while she was cooking. Dhobi means the laundry man and hisab means account. Rasoi means kitchen. Mujhe laga, meri maa sachmuch pagal ho gayi hai. Seeing that, I felt my mother has really become mad. Ve kiske liye aaya hai? In this paragraph, for whom has this word ve been used? Ve shabd Shabana ki maa ke liye aaya hai. It has been used for Shabana's mother. Ve pagli ke andaaz mein kyun baat karti thi? Now, the person who is being referred to as ve, why did she used to talk in the style of a mad person? Uttar, ve pagli drama ke apne role mein khoye rehne ke karan pagli ke andaaz mein baat karne lagti thi. She was participating in a drama called Pagli, and she, because she was very much absorbed in the role of a Pagli, she used to talk in the style of a mad person. Shabana apni maa ko pagal kyun samajhne lagi thi? Why did she start considering her mother as a mad person? Shabana ki maa apne role mein itni khoi rehti thi कि आपसी बातचीत भी पगली के अंदाज में करने लगती थी. शबाना's mother was so much absorbed in her role as a pugli that even while conversing with each other, she would do that in the style of a mad person. कभी धोबी से हिसाब लेते हुए, कभी रसोई में खाना पकाते हुए, इसलिए वह अपनी माँ को पागल समझने लगी थी. Sometimes while settling accounts with the laundryman or while cooking in the kitchen, she would act in the style of a mad person. That is why she started thinking that her mother is mad. Shabana ke mata pita kis kshetra se jude the? Shabana's mother and father, they were associated with which field of work? Kshetra means field, jude the means they were associated. शबाना की माता रंगमंच की प्रसिद्ध कलाकार. शबाना's mother was a famous artist of in the drama field, और पिता शायर थे, and her father was a poet, और हिंदी फिल्मों के लिए गीत भी लिखते थे, and he used to compose songs for Hindi movies. रंगमंच means drama, प्रसिद्ध कलाकार means famous artist. Shayar, a poet. Geet means songs. Vice principal ke saamne Shabana ko kahani kyun gadni padi? Why did Shabana have to make up a story in front of the vice principal? Kahani here means story. Gadni padi means she had to make up. Vice principal ne ek mushaire mein Shabana ke appa ko dekha, to vah unhe un abba se bilkul alag lage जो पेरेंट्स डे पर स्कूल आते थे. When in a concert, the vice principal saw Shabana's father, she felt as if he was totally different from the parent who would come to school on parents' day. हकीकत छिपाने के लिए शबाना को कहानी गढ़नी पड़ी. In order to hide the reality, Shabana had to make up a story. हकीकत means reality, छिपाने के लिए means in order to hide it. शबाना ने अपने पिता से पहला सबक क्या सीखा? What is the first lesson that Shabana learned from her father? Pehla means first, sabak means lesson, sikha means learn. Shabana ne apne pita se pehla sabak yeh sikha ki kamyabi dusron ki nakal mein nahi hai, balki atmavishwas mein hai. Shabana learned the first lesson that Shabana learned from her father is that success is never in copying someone, rather in one's own self-confidence. Kamyabi means success. Nakal means copy. Atmavishwas means self-confidence. Abba Fizul mein apne ko kahan aur kyon uljha lete the? Why did Shabana's father used to engage himself uselessly and where? Abba apne ko Fizul ke kaamon mein. Children, here Fizul mein means uselessly. Abba apne ko Fizul ke kaamon mein uljha lete the. He used to engage himself in some useless works. Jaise ki apni mez ki sabhi darazein saaf karna. Like cleaning all the drawers of his table. Kai khat jo yun hi pade hon unka jawab dena. And to reply to letters lying here and there. Ho sakta hai ve in kaamon ke dauran kya likhna hai sochte rehte the. Maybe it's possible that while doing these works, he used to think as to what to write. Daraze means drawers. Maze means table. Kamon ke dauran means during those works. Sochte rehte the means he used to think. Keep thinking. Unki study ka darwaza bhi khula rehta, aisa kyun kaha gaya? The door of his study room used to be left open. Why has this been particularly mentioned? Darwaza means door. Adhiktar log likhte samay ekant chahte hain. Par Shabana ke abba, jab likhna shuru karte, to ghar mein kitni bhi hangama ho raha ho, unhein koi farak nahi padta tha. Majority of the people, when they write something, they always want silence wherever they are sitting and writing. But Shabana's father, when he would start writing, how much ever furore is there all around in the house, it would never make a difference to him. Children, here adhiktar log means maximum people. Ekant means they want solitude or no sound, nothing. It should be very silent. They want such an atmosphere. But Shabana's father was just the opposite. Hangama means how much ever noise was there in the house, he would never bother. It never made any difference to him. Farak nahi padta tha means it would never make any difference to him. Ve kaam karte samay kabhi khamoshi ka hukm nahi dete the. And he would never order for silence while he was working. Khamoshi means silence. Hukm nahi dete the means he would never order. Hukm means order. Isliye kaha gaya hai ki likhte samay bhi unki study ka darwaza khula rehta. That is the reason why in the lesson it has been mentioned that even while writing, his door would be left open. That is it, children. I hope you all understood it. See you in my next video. Till then, take care and be happy always.